people want to play this game because it's beautiful, because it's got a great story, because it's got a great main character.
This particular moment in his story is interesting because he's still a character that is growing. He's getting control over his destiny, becoming a ruler himself.
Prince is right at that point where soon he's gonna have to start taking very serious responsibilities in his life, and he's looking up to his brother who already is. It's almost like a little glimpse of what the prince will or could become.
The prince has been sent by his father in order to learn a little something from his brother about leading an army and battle.
The prince was supposed to come here in order to learn from his brother. And as he arrives, the castle is already being attacked.
Malik! Is this how you welcome family? You've picked a bad time for a visit.
The attack on his city is going very poorly. He decides to unleash Solomon's army, reputed to be undefeatable.
This army isn't meant for man to use.
You know nothing about the choices a leader must make.
The prince has been through the experiences of Sands of Time. He was the one to open the hourglass.
You don't even know what you're releasing.
Not going to mess with anything else that's magical. Malik says, no, I'm going to do it anyway.
His brother unleashes a sand army that he believed he could control, which he can't. Then all hell breaks loose and the prince has to defend his brother's kingdom.
If you won't stop this, I will.
He will encounter Razia, who is a djinn and the guardian of the water in the palace.
We are Razia, queen of the Marid.
Players might wonder why there's so many water elements that you can freeze in the palace.
This is the desert and they've got water pouring out of all these places where it seems a little bit wasteful. This is one of the ways that this culture is showing its decadence.
King Solomon allied with the four tribes of Jinn. My people, the Marid, moved rivers, bringing life to the desert. But some of us hated that human and Jinn should work together. And the first among them was Ratash.
Razia knows all about the Sand Army, and she helped to originally lock them away. She's obviously super upset when they get unleashed.
Story-wise, going back to the Arabian Nights is kind of going back to a very mythic feeling.
There's also some kind of a nostalgia. We always want to revisit this universe.
It has that Persian, that Arabian Nights exotic feel to it. There's always something mysterious going on, maybe slightly magical.
Ratash and his army must be stopped.
Prince of Persia isn't historical so much as storybook. That magical mix of danger and adventure.